Hello everyone. So in this video we will take another example. So here the example is written. We have three vectors v1, v2 and v3, and you can see that these are linearly independent vectors of R3. So this forms a basis. Now we will try to convert this basis into an orthogonal basis, I can say it's into an orthonormal basis using Gram-Schmidt method. So what we do first? So the first, by the algorithm, what we see, the w1, the first vector, will remain unchanged. So as we have to make it orthonormal, so we will find the norm of the first vector and divide it with that. So our new vector u1, the first vector, should be v1 by norm of v1. So it is 1 0 0 by norm of it. So norm of it means it's a square root of inner product of v1 and v1. So if we see the dot product of v1 and v1, and we are here, the inner product is actually dot product we are considering. So here the norm of first vector is 1. If we can calculate, you can see it is nothing but 1. So our first vector is basically the same. So our u1 is 100. Now we have to calculate the second one, w2. Now for the w2, what do we have to do? We have to take v2 and subtract that v2, the inner product of v2 and u1. So we have to take the inner product and multiply it with u1, and we have to subtract this vector from v2. So it will give us a new vector which is orthogonal to u1, and then we have to normalize it. Basically then we have to divide it with the norm. So at first do this step. So v2 is 1, 1, 0, and so if I take this inner product, it is 1, 1, 0 and 1, 0, 0, and our u1 is 1, 0, 0. So if we calculate it, it is, the inner product is nothing but 1. So 1 into 1, 0, 0, so this will give us, so the first coordinate will be 0, the second coordinate will be 1, and the third one is 0. So it is giving us w2, which is 0, 1, 0. Now what is our w2, what is our u2? u2 is w2 divided by its norm. So the norm of w2, as you can see, this is the standard basis vector 0, 1, 0. So it is 0, 1, 0, and norm is 1 here. So our new second vector is nothing but 0, 1, 0. So you can check that u1 and u2 are orthogonal to each other, and both u1 and u2 are orthonormal also, because their norm is 1. Okay, so let us calculate the third one. So for the third one, similarly we have to take w3 is v3 in inner product with u1, and multiply it with u1. Then we have to subtract v3 inner product it with u2 and multiply it with u2. So our v3 was 1, 1, 1. And if we take this inner product, this is 1, 1, 1, and our u1 is 1, 0, 0. So I write down the u1 here. And now again our v3 is 1, 1, 1. Our u2 is the vector we got, that is 0, 1, 0. So I am writing that down, 0, 1, 0. So if we calculate this, we will get 1, 1, 1. So the first inner product, if we calculate the dot product of it, we will get 1. So this is 1 into 1, 0, 0. The second inner product is also 1. This is 1 into 0, 1, 0. So if we subtract this from 1 on 1, the first two coordinates will be 0, and the third one is 1. And now if we have to normalize it. So after normalizing, we will get the new vector u3, which is w3 by norm of w3. So norm of w3 is 1, so we will get 0, 0, 1 by 1, and that is nothing but 0, 0, 1. So our new set of vector here is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 0, 0, 1. So these are the standard basis which we got by orthogonalization of the given basis. So this is the standard basis, and if you see, if you calculate the inner product of any two vector, you will get 0. And if we calculate the norm of each vector, the norm of each vector is 1. So it's an orthonormal basis. And it is the orthonormal basis corresponding to the basis which we have started with. And we do this Gram-Schmidt, we follow this Gram-Schmidt method, Gram-Schmidt algorithm, and we will get this vector, this set of vectors which forms an orthonormal basis. Thank you.